This is the right kidney showing again the dilated, not the dilated, sorry, the prominence of the renal pyramid. This is the pyramid, this is the pyramid, this one, this one. So there is significant prominence of the medullary pyramids with cortex is normal and the outer surface is normal. Thickness of the parenchyma is normal, corticomedullary distinction is normal. This is the central sinus hypocomplex. This is the upper fold. This is the mid region. This is the arbitrary division just for the learning purpose. This is the lower fold. Now, if this is what happens when the examining technique is wrong, now you see that here you see the prominence of pyramids, okay, throughout. And when I move the probe towards the left side, I see the dilation of all the calluses and with echoes in the dilated calluses. This is the dilation of the calluses, this area. These are the calluses. The area bounded by an echogenic cauliflower-shaped area. This echogenic area is the central sinus echo complex. So the calluses are dilated in the upper fold, in the mid region, and in the lower fold with dilated pelvis. And if you see that in the pelvis, there are sand-like particles, the debris, as it, otherwise, if there had been no debris over here, we should have been seeing the fluid like black, as you are seeing in the middle of the central sinus echo complex. So this is an obstructive uropathy. With possible infection. Now you see that these are the dilated calluses, fluid in the dilated calluses, urine in the dilated calluses, with debris in the proximal ureter as well. And you note that the prominence of the pyramids. But you know the normal, when you will scan the normal, you will come to know that usually the pyramids are not so prominent. So this is a case of obstructive uropathy with no dilation of the proximal ureter. You see, this is the proximal ureter, this area, and it measures 4.4. Normal should not exceed more than 7 millimeters, so there is no dilation of the proximal ureter. Now the cause of this pathology, this obstructive uropathy, lies in the urinary bladder. As you will see that there is a calculus in the right urothelial junction. This is the urinary bladder and this is the urothelial junction, right one, and this is the calculus measuring 6.3 millimeters. This is the these are the seminal vesicles in transverse section. So the cause is very obvious. It is because of this calculus. Here you see it does give a bit posterior shadowing. In longitudinal section, we'll be able to see in longitudinal section as well, and here we are. Now this is the calculus. This is the dilated uterovesical junction. This is the calculus and this is the shadow, posterior shadow. So this is a case of obstructive uropathy due to calculus in the right ureterovesical junction.